Hello, beautiful people. 2022 is here, and I have three Streamyard tips to share with you, and I've never shared these before. Two of the three tips I actually found out from other Streamyard users, and one that I discovered, but I don't see anyone else talking about. And I think that, or most of us are using Streamyard anyway, and even if we don't use it, we see others using it. So we still need to know these features. All right. So the first one that I want to share is the one that I found by mistake. Well, I found it serendipitously. And that is solving a big problem that we have with Facebook. When you're live on StreamYard and you get a lot of comments, and we do have this starred comment feature in StreamYard, which is very, very helpful. But what you want to do is always make sure that you answered everyone's question. So when the stream is over, even though you've started some comments, you still want to make sure you go back and thank people who left comments or say hi or whatever. Finding that on Facebook is like looking for a needle in a haystack, because especially if the comments are threaded, it's horrible trying to get in. But there's a simple way to do that, as long as you've gone live using StreamYard. And I'm going to show you how it works. Let's go into your past broadcasts. So you're on your StreamYard account, and instead of going to the upcoming tab, you want to go to the past tab. Okay, so look for anywhere you were actually live on Facebook. So here's the one that I want to go into, and it was how to use Spotify. And you, typically we go here, we download or we embed it or whatever, but I want to go into the studio. Now, this feature is unique to Facebook. So before you even ask, I'm just going to let you know that it's unique to Facebook. Those comments that came in during my stream are still there. So if I wanted to make sure I connect with Richard, you don't have it on your Android devices, LOL, I can see that comment is there, and I know that I can make sure that I respond to him. Barb made a comment and checked into Anchor for the first time in a long time, didn't realize I had changed so much about the account. Okay. So also another tip that I know has been shared, when you have a comment displayed, if you want to take that comment down, you do not have to go to unhide. All you have to do is click your space bar. Okay. So that was a tip within a tip. And there was another comment that I don't think I ever got a chance to respond to. Anchor Spotify has been a get around to it priority for me, much to think about based on your update. Okay. So that is my super secret hidden tip to make sure that you've responded to all of your past comments on any of your Facebook Lives. Just go in here and go to all of your streams that were done on Facebook. Okay, tip number two. This one is from my buddy, Michael Daniels. And this is the fancy text generator. You may notice I have a different font here on my name here. This is not the font that you would see typically in StreamYard, but my friend Michael Daniels over from Tinkering with Tech, he does that show with Heather, he did a demo, and I said, how did you do that? And so he showed me how it's done, and it's lingojam.com/fancy text generator. So you can generate all kinds of fancy fonts. And then all you have to do is paste them into Streamyard. And so here, we'll put some text in here, and I'll just say fancy text. And here's all these different fonts. I think one of the ones that I like is this one. Come back over here. And now I'm going to put up a different banner. Put up this one. And look, it's got the fancy text. So we're not stuck with the text the way StreamYard has it set up for us. And I'm sure there's other tools that you can use to do this, but it's just something that I never knew that we could do before. And so I'm super happy about it because I love the fact that now my name can show up with the I looks like an I instead of looking like an L. All right. So this last tip I actually got from watching the latest StreamYard at StreamYard with our friend Melanie Dyann Howe. She is amazing. And something told me, as much as I know StreamYard like the back of my hand, something told me watch this because she's going to cover something that I didn't know. And so she shared this cool tip that is actually a Chrome tip. And that is the Chrome tab preview. So now when you do a screen share, and I'm just going to solo that. So now when you do a screen share from a tab in Chrome, and you see how I have the list there, and I have StreamYard at the top, and then I had thumbnail ideas, which is my name of my folder in Canva, which I'll show you one day. And then I had another StreamYard, but what I did was when I clicked on the Canva one, it gave me a preview of that tab. It simplifies the idea of you sharing your tabs. You have multiple tabs open, and come on, let's admit it. We always have multiple tabs open, even though we shouldn't, when we're live streaming, we should just have the ones open that we know we're going to use. But just, that's not life in reality. So there you have it. There's my three hidden features of StreamYard. Number one is being able to see the old chat inside of any of your past Facebook live streams. And then the next one is the fancy fonts that we can add on our banners and so forth. And then the last one is the Chrome tab preview. Three things that can help you with your StreamYard live streams. Have a great day. And as always, stay beautiful.